Namaste. Welcome to the lecture series on the subject Applied Thermodynamics. This is module 5 in their part 1 Reciprocating Compressors, lecture number 2. Myself, Dr. N. Satish Kumar, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Canara Engineering College, Pantwal. So in the last lecture, we derived an expression for the work of compression for polytrophic compression using PV diagram for the case without clearance. Okay, now we'll do the derivation for the polytropic compression work with the clearance. So you can see here in the PV diagram, so 1 to 2 is the compression. You see, you can see 1 to 2 is the compression, 2 to 3 is the delivery, but you can see the point 3 is not touching this axis here, so there is small gap. So small volume of space is left out at the end of the delivery, compression and delivery, so that some compressed air occupies this space. So usually when this is the case, so this compressed air which is occupying the space expands first when the piston starts moving from this TDC till it reaches here. So piston starts moving from this end to this end. So when till it reaches here, so there is the expansion of this compressed air only takes place. Further, there will be drop in pressure. So then actual suction takes place from 4 to 1. So this is the end of the stroke. Okay, the stroke from here to here. Okay, so this is what you have to understand. So initially there will be small compressed air which is already left out in the clearance volume will expand in the beginning from 3 to 4, and the actual suction begins from 4 to 1. Now the net work input, that is work of compression, is nothing but area under the PV diagram. Right, so area under the PV diagram, so WC, so like in the previous case, so it is nothing but P2 V2 minus P1 V1 by N minus 1, that is for the process 1 to 2, area below this. Then the area of this rectangle for the process 2 to 3, that is P2 into V2 minus V3, area of the rectangle, then minus the area or the work done during the process 3 to 4, which is nothing but the area below 3 to 4, which is nothing but P3 V3 minus P4 V4 by N minus 1. And also you have to subtract the work of this suction 4 to 1, P1 into V1 minus P4. So for your information, once again I repeat this, how do you wrote this formula and all, okay? So here, see, the work of compression is nothing but the area 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. 1, 2, this hatched portion. This is this area enclosed by this inside this. So for that, so what you have to do is you see, if you take area or the work done during process 1 to 2, so it will cover entire area. You see, this much it will cover, which is direct formula because it is a polytropy compression. So P2 V2 minus P1 V1 by N minus 1. Now area under 2 to 3 means, once again, it is a rectangle, you can see here. So this complete rectangle, okay, like this. So this is nothing but P2 into V2 minus V3. Now this also covers this extra area. You see, whatever you have taken now, so that has to be subtracted, including this part, okay, including this small part also. So for that, minus of this 3 to 4 work here, this work which covers this area, so that much is reduced now. Then also area below 4 to 1, then this is also eliminated, so that you will get a work or net area as only this much, okay, between this 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So this is how you have to do. So here during process 3 to 4, the work of expansion is P3 V3 minus P4 V4 by N minus 1, and during suction is P1 into V1 minus V4. Now continuing, so P2 is equal to P3 and P1 is equal to P4. So after simplification, you'll get it as, because after substituting these conditions, so you get it as P2 V2 minus P1 by N minus 1, here P2 V2 minus P1 V1, and here P3 V3 minus P4 V4 by N minus 1, last term is P3 V3 minus P4 V4, some rearrangement of the terms. Now from the first two terms you can take p2 v2 minus p1 v1 common outside. Inside the bracket you will get 1 by n minus 1 plus 1. And in the second term you will get p3 v3 minus p4 v4 outside common. So inside the bracket 1 by n minus 1 plus 1. So I request all my students to, instead of listening to this lecture, so you take material, writing materials, and work out this simplification. So here after simplification this becomes n by n minus 1. So p2 v2 minus p1 v1 here minus n by n minus 1 p3 v3 minus p4 v4. So first term if you take p1 v1 outside, so inside the bracket p2 by p1 into v2 by v1 minus 1. Second term p4 v4 if you take outside, so it becomes p3 by p4 into v3 by v4 minus 1. So all these are the simplifications. Now here this p2 by p1, right, into v2 by p1, so you can write as p2 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n, and here p3 by p4 into v3 by v4 you can write as p3 by p4 to the power n minus 1 by n. So further simplification, n by n minus 1 p1 v1, so this term is as it is. So here p4 is equal to p1, so second term n by n minus 1, so you can see p4 is replaced by p1, and inside the bracket also p3 is equal to p2 and p4 is equal to p1, so you can write as p4 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1, because p4 is equal to p1 and p3 by p4 is equal to p2 by p1. So here once again you can take this p2 by p1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1 common, so you'll get v1 minus v4. So this is already outside. So this v1 minus v4 is nothing but the volume during the process 1 to 4. If you recall the PV diagram, that is nothing but the actual volume of air drawn during the suction stroke, actual suction, so that is VA. So that V1 minus V4 you can consider as VA, which is the actual volume of air drawn in at suction pressure and temperature, because as I told you earlier, so 3 to 4 the compressed air expands, okay. So from 4 to 1 the actual suction begins, okay. So this you can also write as MA into V1, small VA, that volume can also be written as mass into specific volume, okay, because that is the total volume VA, so it's a mass into specific volume at the inlet conditions. So you can write as WC, the work of compression, as n by n minus 1 MA into P1 V1 into P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1, where this V1 is nothing but the specific volume at the inlet conditions. So P1 V1 you can write as RT1 also. So you can get one more expression for the compressor work as n by n minus 1 MA into RT1 into P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. So if you want power input, then it is MA into RT1 P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1, because MA, so mass flow rate in kg per second, so this work itself, it gives the power. Or you have to MA into MA RT1, so, or you can write it as also P1 into V1. So V1 is nothing but MA into small V1, so this also gives the work or power output of the, or power input, sorry, not output, power input to the compressor. So compressor is a work absorbing device, so this work out input will be always negative. So now from this expression what you can see is the work of compression is same if it is with or without clearance volume. The reason is without clearance volume there is no issue, but with clearance volume, so whatever the work of expansion, that is the initial part 3 to 4, so that will be derived from the compressed air itself, so no extra work is required. So for the same volume of the same stroke length, so the compression with or without clearance is same, because the actual suction which is taking place from 4 to 1, for the same volume of suction without clearance, the work is same. So that is what, the work of compression is same with or without clearance, so clearance doesn't affect the work of compression. Now expression for work of compression using steady flow analysis. So treating entire the compressor operations as a steady flow process, so work transfer is given by minus integration of VdP, minus because it is a compressor, work input is there, and work of compression WC. So once you write work of compression, no need to write minus again. So it is integration of 1 to 2 VdP. Okay. Now let us do it for each of these process one by one. So WC is given by 1 to 2 integration 1 to 2 VdP. So here first we'll doing for the isentropy compressor. Okay, isentropy compression. Okay, PV to the power gamma is equal to constant. So PV to the power gamma is equal to C or V. Now you have substitute for V here. See, this type of derivations you did it in the BTD also in the work and heat chapter. So you have substitute for, you are substituting for P there, but I'm doing it for V here. So V is equal to C1 P to the power 1 by gamma. Okay, because here this is a new constant is denoted by C1. So what happens is, in place of V, if you substitute C1 by P to the power 1 by gamma, so we'll get this C1 into dP by P to the power 1 by gamma, C1 take outside. So integration of 1 by P to the power 1 by gamma, so it is P to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma divided by 1 minus 1 by gamma from P1 to P2. And after simplification, you'll get, so once again, I request you to simplify this. If there is any mistake, I don't think there is any mistake, but please do correct it. Okay. C1 into P2 to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma minus P1 to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma into gamma by gamma minus 1. So gamma by gamma minus 1 can be taken outside. So here P1 to the power 1 by gamma into V1. Here P2 to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma minus P1 to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma. So C1 is equal to Vp to the power 1 by gamma. So that you are substituting here. Okay, so substituting for initial condition, it becomes C1 is equal to P1 V1. So that is what here. So C1 is replaced by P1 to the power 1 by gamma into V1. Now bringing P1 outside from these two terms, if you bring P1 outside, so first term becomes P2 by P1 to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma, second term is 1. So that take P1 to the power 1 minus 1 by gamma is taken outside. This is as such. And here you can see this is power 1 by gamma, this is power 1 minus 1 by gamma. So 1 by gamma gets cancelled, it becomes just P1 and V1 as it is. So inside the bracket is also as it is. This is per kg of air, work of compression for the isentropic process. So this can also be written as P1 V1, you can write as RT1. So WC is equal to gamma by gamma minus 1 RT1 P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1. So this is work of compression using steady flow analysis for isentropic work. If ME is the mass flow rate of air through the compressor, the power input required to drive the compressor is given by gamma minus 1 ME RT1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1, or it can also be written as gamma by gamma minus 1 into P1 V1 capital V1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1. So here V1 is the volume flow rate of air at inlet conditions. Okay, that is nothing but MA into small V1, that is specific volume. Now coming to the expression for work of compression for polytrophy compression. So PV to the power N is equal to constant. So here it is the same formula, WC is integration VdP. So one difference is, so you have to replace n gamma by n, the previous derivation. So wherever gamma is there, so you have to replace it by n. So you'll get the work of compression as n by n minus 1 P1 V1 into P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1, or n by n minus 1 RT1 P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n minus 1. Okay, so polytrophy compression derivation is same as isentropy compression, only thing is you have to replace gamma by n. Now coming to the isothermal compression, so which is PV is equal to constant, or PV is equal to C, or C is equal to, or sorry, V is equal to C by P. Okay, PV is equal to C, sorry, P, V is equal to C. So you want V, so V is equal to C by P. Okay, similar to the previous case. So that is what is substituted. Wc is integration from 1 to 2 vdp. So v is nothing but c by p. You can see here integration with respect to dp. So c you can take outside. So integration of dp pi is nothing but ln p from p1 to p2. So you get c as you can replace it as pv, or for initial conditions you can apply it as p1 v1. So c should be replaced by p1 v1 and ln p, and applied with the limits you will get upper limit and lower limit ln p2 minus ln p1, which is nothing but ln p2 by p1. So this is simple mathematics. I don't want to elaborate on this. So you can also write it as rt1 ln p2 by p1. Or power required is ma rt1 ln p2 by p1, or p1 v1 ln p2 by p1. Okay, so this is the work of compression using for isothermal compression. Now coming to the adiabatic compressor efficiency. So here adiabatic or isentropic compression is treated as the ideal process and compared with the actual compression in terms of the respective work inputs. So for comparison purpose, so we are taking isentropic compression as the ideal process and the best process, right? So actual compression is compared with respect to the adiabatic or isentropic compression. So hence we get a term called adiabatic compressor efficiency, which is nothing but adiabatic compressor input to the actual input. Okay, so adiabatic compressor input always will be less, actual compressor input will be more. So this becomes adiabatic efficiency of the compressor with a quantity less than 1. Sometimes the actual compression process is approximated by a polytropic process with a suitable value of index between 1 and gamma. In such case, the actual work output or work input, that is polytropic work input, is less than the adiabatic compression input, hence the adiabatic compressor efficiency will be more than 100%. So there's a possibility is there. So in actual compression process is approximated to polytropic process. So in that case, because polytropic process the index varies from 1 to gamma, so there's a possibility that this polytropic or actual work input becoming less than the adiabatic compression input. So in that case, if the denominator becomes less and numerator becomes more, as all of you know, the efficiency exceeds 100%. Then coming to the isothermal compressor efficiency, so this is nothing but the comparison between actual compression and the isothermal compression. So isothermal compressor efficiency is given by isothermal work of compression divided by actual work of compression, but this is always less than 100% because isothermal work of compression is always minimum. Okay. Then coming to the mechanical efficiency, the power supplied to the compressor from an external source, that is maybe motor or engine, at the input shaft is called as a brake power or the shaft power. So power input given to the compressor from an external source is called as a brake power or the shaft power. The power transferred from piston to the gas. Now power at the end of the compression, so what is available for compression to compress the air inside the machine, so this is called as indicated power. See, what you are supplying to the compressor shaft is brake power or the shaft power. What is available for compression, because there may be some losses due to friction and other things, so power available for actual compression will be less. Okay, so which can you can find out using an indicator diagram, which I will explain later in the IC engine chapter, the indicator diagram. So the indicator power is always less than the shaft power because of the friction losses. This is just I told you now. So frictional power is nothing but BP minus IP. So actual power input what you are giving is a brake power or the shaft power, which is more than indicator power. So the difference of brake power and the indicator power is the frictional power in case of compressor. You see, since it is a work absorbing device, so frictional power loss is BP minus IP. Okay, the extent of losses due to friction is expressed in terms of mechanical efficiency. So the loss from BP to IP, because BP is more, IP is less, so there is some frictional loss. So this is accounted in terms of a efficiency called as mechanical efficiency, which is nothing but eta mechanical is equal to IP by BP. Note, this is applicable only for compressor, which is a work absorbing device. For a work producing device, the IP will be more and BP will be less. It will become BP by IP, like in case of IC engine. So here it is IP by BP or IP by shaft power. IP is indicator power, BP is the brake power, SP is the shaft power. So with this I conclude this lecture number 2 of this module 5, and will continue in the lecture number 3 next class. Thank you.